After learning the various types of operations which they are using in the milling machine, now let us next go for types of milling cutters. So there are the basic types of milling cutters are plane, slab, end milling cutter, face milling cutter, metal slitting cutter, next angle milling cutter, formed milling cutter, wood rough key milling cutter, next T slot milling cutter, and the last one is fly milling cutter. So there are number of milling cutters. Among them, if you are trying to observe, this is one of the case where slab mill cutter. So here we are having the workpiece. The workpiece is at this position. Okay. So on the top surface, we need to be machined. So it is positioned in this case. And here the axis of the workpiece is in this direction and the workpiece is in this direction. Since both are parallel, we can able to term it as a peripheral milling. Okay, so this is by the use of a slab mill cutter. This is also similar case of a slab mill cutter where the workpiece width is more up. And this is one of the case where the manufacturing of I section beams or railway beams and all, they need to have the side surfaces to be machined carefully. And this is the option for two side cutter. And this is a one of the category of the cutter called as end milled cutter, which is used for manufacturing of a slot. Suppose a billet is there with me, so I need to prepare exactly a slot like this. For example, in the case of a compound slide, we can see that compound slide adjustments and all. Okay, so these kinds and all we can able to manufacture by using this kind of end mill cutter. The other one is a staggered tooth cutter. So this is basically used in keyway manufacturing. In most of the cases, it is used for keyway manufacturing. And the next one is an angle cutter. So we can able to see certain angle here. Okay, some angle, let's say it is a 45 or like that. Some angle will be there that is going to be termed as an angle cutter. And this is called as a form cutter. Form cutter talks about different types of form tool. So whatever the shape of the tool is there, depending upon the tool shape, we are getting the shape. Here you can see some kind of a concave shape, and here we can able to see some kind of a convex shape on the top surface of the work pieces. These are some categories of milling cutters. And again, here you can see some cutters like corner round cutter, where this particular shape will be having some kind of a corner round. So they are trying to term it as a corner round cutter. Convex formed cutter, the shape of that particular cutter is convex shape. And this is one kind of a gear tooth cutter we have earlierly seen in other slides, as I can quickly show you. So this is one kind of a cutter, okay, as we are seeing. Next, gear tooth cutter. Next one is a single angle cutter. So single angle means we can able to see only one particular angle on the top surface. This is called as a single angle, and this is called as a double angle. Here one angle and here one angle, two angles, double angle. And earlier we have discussed about convex. Now we are talking about the concave formed cutter. So like that, we are having different types of cutters, also milling cutters. The cutters basically depends upon the type of milling operation which we are trying to use. And the most important for most of the competitive exams are this nomenclature of the milling cutter. So if you observe, this is a case where the shaft is going to be mounted, and we can able to see the keyway here. Okay, keyway here, and here this angle we are going to draw one perpendicular end and one inclined end. This talks about the rake angle. So basically, the rake angle is the angle where the cutter surface will be having a coincidence to the workpiece. Okay, and this is called as a land of the cutter. So if you observe any milling cutter, it will have some land and it will have some edge, and then it is having some deeper edge. Again, it will produce like that. This surface we will be talking about the land. and pitch means from one particular teeth end to another particular end starting position. This is called as a pitch, and this surface we will talking about a heel. This is called as a heel. So these are the main things which we need to know in the milling cutter. Next we will go with some kind of angles here. So relief angle, so you can observe the relief angle here. Okay, basically the relief angle is not mentioned in this particular diagram, but basically it occurs in this particular portion. Okay, it is the land of the tooth and the tangent done outside the cutting parameter. And the next one is a primary clearance angle. So this is the primary clearance angle. This primary clearance angle will be back of the tooth with a line drawn to the tangent. So here if you assume that one as a circle, we are drawing a tangent here, a line drawn to the tangent and to the periphery of the cutter, we are getting an angle. This is called as a primary clearance angle. And in the earlier case we have discussed about the rake angle also, no? So this rake angle talks about with respect to face of the tooth and the radial line, a vertical line, or we will term most of the cases in 90 degrees line, okay, orthogonal line. And lip angle, so this is the lip angle. The lip angle basically it is between the angle of the land of the face and to the tooth surface. This is the tooth. So this is the tooth and this is the angle line, and this is called as a lip angle. And apart from that one, we will have some fillet edges also at the side of the cases. So these are the various kinds of angles. And one most important angle here called as helix angle. So helix angle is not represented here. So helix angle will be the angle which the cutting edge with a helical cutting edge. So if you observe for the milling cutter, it will be having some kind of an angles with respect to the surface. So this part they will be talking about the helix angle. So helix cutting edge making a plane corresponding to contain with respect to some kind of axis to the cylindrical cutter. So this is called as a helix angle.